Hello guys, do you want to stop making mistakes in adding up numbers using the sum function in Excel? The subtotal function is the solution to this. I'm going to show you how it works and include a shortcut in the end, so keep hanging. Right here we have a table of salary data from different departments and different functions. The subtotal function has different options in it, and the best way is to show you by example. So we select the cell over here. We're gonna insert subtotal, and here there are several options. You can see the average, count, the maximum, minimum, and also the sum. So we want to see the average salary of all the different functions. So we select one, and then we select the range. Shows the average salary. We can also use subtotal to see the sum of the salaries. So we insert subtotal again, and now we select number 9, the sum, and again the same range, and it shows over here. Subtotal also can show the maximum amount, the highest salary, so let me show that one as well. So that's number 4, maximum, and we include the same range. So now you think subtotal is not so special, why I'm not using sum? That's much more easier to check all the same salaries from a specific department. Well, let me put the sum function over here. Right now it shows the same sum for the subtotal function and the sum function, but this is where the magic happens. I'm gonna select the department of operations. And you can see here that subtotal correctly adds up 3 different salaries, and you can see that the sum function keeps adding up all the rows that are filtered out right now. So you're making a mistake by looking at this number. So that's one of the most important reasons that subtotal is better than sum. The subtotal function will only base its information on the filtered visible rows. As you can see here, for the average salary, for the sum of the salaries, and for the highest salary, they all match. So the subtotal function is really convenient. But first, do you want to know more about how to use the most powerful functions in Excel? Subscribe to our channel for more. Finally, there's a shortcut for using the subtotal function. You have to select the cells you want to add up, and you press Alt plus the is sign on the keyboard, and then the subtotal function shows up over here. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give a thumbs up, and see you at the next video.